طيب in this lecture we will talk about الـ diodes in deep. We have many types of the diode, the ideal diode, regular diode, the zener and many other types of diodes. We are concerned in this lecture about regular diodes. Regular diode is a specific type or special type of a diode in such that it works only on the forward bias, and in the reverse it doesn't have any current. For the forward, it connects the current only if the depletion region or the internal voltage of the diode to be greater than 0.7. So if the diode has internal voltage greater than 0.7, the current will have a value, and the current will pass through the circuit. Okay, so a regular diode is a diode that has internal voltage. Okay, for the ideal diode, it has it works as only a short circuit in the diode, or it doesn't have any internal voltage in it. Okay, طيب. As we discussed before, any diode has two biasing connections, the forward bias or a reverse bias. For the diode to work in the forward bias, this will be the characteristic curve that relate between the voltage and the current values in the diode. The current value in the circuit or in the diode will be always be zero. It will start to have a value if the voltage across the diode be greater than 0.7. So we will have a high value of the current. But in the reverse bias, we will have the voltage across the diode will be zero, and so on for the current. But in some point, at some point, the voltage across the diode may have a value, and the current can pass through the circuit. But the diode will be broken since it will enter to the breakdown region, and it will be broken. Okay. طيب. This ثواني. In this circuit, in this IV characteristic curve, I am assuming that I have a circuit like this. I have a diode in a series with a resistor, and I will have a battery. Okay. This will be the positive part of the diode, or positive part, and this will be the positive part of the battery. If the depletion region, if this diode is called regular, this means that it will have 0.7 internal voltage across it. So you will find that the circuit will connect a current in this connection. But if I have a diode to be connected in reverse with a battery. Okay, we will find that in the diode in this case will work as reverse, and there is no current in this circuit that is shown as in this characteristic curve. We will not have any value. The voltage will be zero and the current will be zero. But at some point, if you find a value of current in this in the reverse, this is called the breakdown region, and the diode will be broken. Okay, it's a behavior of the diode in this case. Yeah. Fine. What will be the circuit? What will be the shape of the circuit of the diode in the circuit? We may find the circuit like this, or we may have many diodes in the circuit. Usually, we the usual circuit we have. We may مثلا find a diode is connected in series with another diode. We may find this a connected to a battery. Okay, we call this circuit as a closed circuit. or a common circuit that we are used to work with. But according to this circuit, this is a normal, not normal circuit that we used to work with. So if I have two diodes in this circuit as shown here, I couldn't decide which one is connected to the positive and which one is connected to the negative. In this circuit, I found that the positive is connected to positive, so this diode is forward, and here the negative is connected to negative, so this diode only, also are is forward. So these two diodes are forward. Okay, so for these types of circuits, I can decide easily the shape of the diode forward or reverse. Okay. But according to this type of circuits, I couldn't decide. So I would like I will make an assumption. I will assume that these two diodes are say on, or these two diodes are forward, and I will check the values at the end to be matched with this assumption. If I am assuming that this diode is forward and this diode is forward, this means that I will have current value in this branch and I will have current value in this branch. So I will decide finally that this is a correct assumption. Here we have four possible assumptions. I may assume that diode one is on and diode two is on. Or I can assume that both diodes are off, okay? Or I can assume that one of them is on and another one of them is off, on, off. Or the second diode is off and the first, sorry, the first, the second diode is on and the first diode is off. These are the possible cases of assumptions. So you have to start say, I will assume that D1 is on and D2 is on, and make my answer. Then check finally the values of the current in this branch and the current in this branch. If these current values is greater than or equal zero, this greater than zero, this means that my assumption is correct. If I'm assuming that this diode is on and the second diode is on, and I found that the current in this branch is مثلا negative, is negative one. Current in this branch is negative one. Current in this branch is negative two. So my assumption is wrong, since I'm assuming that on, which means forward, which means that there is a current. If I find the value of the current to be negative one, so my assumption will be wrong. This will be this illustrated according during our answer of this question. Okay, time. Here for this example, I have two diodes. For the first side, I don't know how, if these two diodes are forward or reverse, so I will make an assumption. But the question is, using the constant voltage drop diode, find the values of the labeled voltage and the constant. Constant voltage drop diode is a regular diode, is another term of a regular diode, which means that this diode has an internal voltage across it equal 0.7 if this type of diode is in silicon. The question is, he would like to get the values of Li and V. Li is the current that passed through diode 1, and V is the point A is out of diode 2. Okay. First of all, we'll make an assumption that diode 1 is on and diode 2 is on. Okay. If diode is diode 1 is on, this means that this diode is in the circuit, is will be drawn in circuit normally. If the diode is this diode is on, this means that it will be correct, it will be drawn in a circuit normally. So this will be the circuit. But I know that in there is a relation between LV in and LV out of any diode. I know that the internal voltage across this point is 0.7. This means that if I have a value here, say 10, so the value out of this diode will be say 9.3. okay, since the diode will minimize it by 0.7. okay, so there is a relation between the V out and the V in of the diode. The V out equal the V in minus 0.7. So if you have a VN of the diode, which is this point, to be say 10. ال V out اللي هي this point will be 10 minus 0.7 which is 9.3. okay, this is the relation between ال V out and ال V in for the regular diode. If we would like to go through this rule in this example, we can find that we can find that this point, which is the out of diode 1, which is the out of diode 1, is equal to 0 since it is connected to the ground. So ال V, ال V in minus 0.7 will equal to 0. ال V, if we refer to this point as VA, VA, and this point as VB, so ال VA is the in is the in is the VN of this diode. So ال VA minus 0.7 minus 0 equal ال V ال V out. Okay, I have 0 VN 0 equal equal ال VA minus 0.7. Okay, so ال VA will equal 0.7. I have ال V out equal ال VN minus 0.7. So ال 0 equal ال VA minus 0.7. ال VA will be ال 0.7. Okay, طيب, using the same rule, if I would like to get the value of ال VB, if I would like to get the value of ال VB, ال VA is the input of the diode 2, of diode 2. Okay, so ال rule will be ال VB equal ال VA minus 0.7. And I find that ال VA equal 0.7, so the VB will equal to 0. ال VB equal to 0, which is the value of ال B, ال V, or the required value of ال V. Okay? So, using, I will assume that diode 1 is on, diode 2 is on. Using this rule, V out equal V in minus 0.7, this will be the V out of diode 1, and this will be the VA. So VA minus 0.7 equals 0, so VA will equal 0.7. And for diode 2, this will be the V in, and this will be the V out. So VB equal VA minus 0.7, so V will equal to 0. Okay? طيب, till the moment I get the value of LV, LV. I would like to get the value of the current in this branch. As we can see, this as you can see, the voltage at this point is plus 3, voltage at this point is 0, voltage at this point equal negative 3. So this will be, this is the greater, agreed value, this is 0.7 and this is 3 and so on. So the current will pass in this direction from the higher value of the voltage to the lower value of the voltage. It will be in this direction. So if I refer to the current in this branch as I3 or I total, the I total will equal I1. This is I1 and this is I2. Okay, so I1 plus I2 equal I total. Okay, the current will go through these two branches. To get the value of I total, it will be positive 3 minus 0.7 over 5, which will be 0.546. If I would like to get the value of I2, it will be the volt at this point, minus the volt at this point over 10, which is 0 minus minus 3 over 10 will be 0.3. So according to this rule, I total equal I1 plus I2. I get the value of I2 total, I get the value of I2, so the I1 will be I total minus I2, which will be 0.16. Till the moment I find that the I1 greater than 0 and the I2 greater than 0, so my assumption is correct. since this assumption means that the diodes are on and means that the diodes has a current across across it. Okay. For the example, these two diodes are on. You will find more examples on the sheet about having that the first assumption that you are testing is wrong assumption that so you will have another you will have to try another assumption. Okay. In some cases for the diode you may have an AC diode, not DC diode. AC alternating current, not DC current. What's the difference between the AC current and the DC current? The difference that the DC has a specific direction and a specific peak value of the voltage, but the AC has a change in the peak and a change in direction. Okay, so if I can simulate the input as sine wave. If I can simulate the input as sine wave, AC, it will be sometimes positive and another time will be negative. So the same diode may work as forward and reverse at the same point, at the same time, or in the same circuit. This will be the main idea of AC. Again, the diode can work for DC DC voltage source or AC voltage source. The difference between the AC and the DC is that the AC has can be simulated as a sine wave, which means that it is positive. It will have positive values at some points or some time. For the coming times, it will be negative values of the voltage. So the diode maybe work as forward at this. Part of the sine wave and the reverse at this part of the sine wave. Okay, before answering this question in detail, I have to discuss the possible cases of the diodes to be collected in the AC. I have two possible cases of connecting الديودز in the circuit. I may have مثلا الفولتج الباتري is connected to الديود such that I have only one diode is in series with another diode. Okay, resistor and so on. I may have many يعني this series. Okay, or I may have ال voltages are collected in parallel. أشو. Okay. Or I may have a combination of them. I may have مثلا one diode is connected to many diodes in parallel. Okay, so what will be the behavior of the diode in most cases or in all cases? Okay, for the diodes to work in the series, this is called the parallel. Okay, these are the combination. This is a combination between parallel and the series. For the series connection, if I have a DC or DC voltage source, say مثلا 10. So this is 0.7 if it is in silicon, and this is 0.7 if it is in silicon. So the voltage value at this point, the behavior of the diodes will be 10 minus 0.7 will be 9.3. Okay, Then the 9.3 will be work as an input to the second diode. So we will say that 9.3 minus 0.7 will be 8.6. This will be the behavior of diodes that work in series. The input of the diode is the output of the diode will work as an input to another diode. But for the parallel diodes, if I have 10 here, this 10 voltage will work as an input to this diode, and this 10 will work as an input to the second diode. Then the final voltage value will be the summation of the both values. Okay. So the input will enter the two diodes in parallel together at the same time. This will be a combination. I will have, مثلا, say 10 here. We will enter to this diode. The voltage at this point will be 9.3. This 9.3 will work as an input to this diode and this diode. Okay. Okay. We will find. يعني we will solve. يعني in the section we will solve all possible cases in this diode. But we can solve this question in the lecture as a practicing. We can answer this question as a practice. Okay. We have to write it here again. I may myself find this circuit, a diode, another diode. And another diode is in parallel to this diode. Okay. I will have here a resistor and the ground. The question is to find the value of LV out here, assuming that the input is a sine wave. Okay. The question is how to find the output sine wave in this circuit. Okay, the output will be something like this: positive zero, positive zero, and so on. How to find this value? It will be 8.6, 8.6 in positive and zero in negative. Okay. How can we find this, trace this circuit to be 8.6? Okay. We'll solve this question in two phases. When the Vn, this is the Vn, which simulates the input sine wave. If the Vn is greater than or equal to zero, which means that positive values, or the Vn, Vn is greater than less than or equal to zero. Vn is less than or equal to zero, which means that negative values. If the sine wave, the positive sine wave, is entering into this diode, so this will be the positive value of the diode, which is connected to positive values of the sine wave. So this diode will be forward. So it will be in the circuit, drawn in the circuit normally. This diode will be forward. So if I have a peak value 10, so this value will be 9.3. Okay. So assume this is called Vx. Okay. So Vx will equals to Vn minus 0.7. Okay. If the Vn is 10, it will be 9.3. If it will be 8, it will be 8 minus 0.3. If it will be 5, it will be 5 minus 0.3, minus 0.7, and so on. Here the Vx will work as an input to this diode and it is a positive value. Okay, this will be a positive value. This is the positive value of positive part of the diode, and this is a negative part. So this diode will work as forward, and this diode will work as reverse. So the circuit will be, since this positive is connected to negative. Okay, so this will be reverse. And the positive is connected to positive, so this diode will be forward. Reverse means that it is not will not be drawn in the circuit. So the circuit will be something like this. Okay. This is V out. ال في ان في اكس this will be the في اوت. So if ال في ان is 10, so ال في اكس will be 9.3 وال في اوت will be 9.3 minus 0.7 since this diode is a is forward. So it will be 8.6. Okay, this will be for the positive cycle. This will be the response of the positive cycle. For the negative cycle, here, a negative cycle means I will have negative values. So, negative values will be connected to the to a diode with the positive part of the diode. So this diode will be a open circuit. Okay. So the VN will not be connected to the other circuit, other remaining circuit. Okay. So the circuit will be open, and this V out will be connected directly to a ground here. Okay. Ground. The V out. For the negative values of the VN. This diode will be reverse, so it will be open circuit. So there is no current, and so there is no change in voltage, and the V out will connect directly to the ground. We the V out will equal to zero. Okay. So this will be the response of the diode in the negative part. Okay. This is the question, and this is the answer of this type of circuits. Section you may have different types of circuits, or we can explain it in deep in the coming lectures. This is all for this circuit for the regular diodes. Okay. We have many types of diodes. Either regular Zener diode. The regular is the type of diode that have internal voltage across it, which equal to 0.7 in case that it is formed from a silicon material. The IV characteristic curve of regular diode is that in the relation between the IV and the V in the forward will be something like that. It will have a current in the circuit if the voltage across the diode will be greater than 0.7, and it usually have zero voltage and zero current in the reverse, but at some point it may have a specific high value of the current which may result in the diode to be broken. If we have the diodes in the circuit and would like to get the values in the circuit, we have to make an assumption to follow on the result of the circuit, the values in the circuit. Our assumption may be correct or may be wrong if you assume that the diode is on. So the value at this diode should be greater than zero. If you are assuming that the diode is off, this means that the current across this diode will be greater than or equal zero. You have to change your assumption if the values doesn't match with the assumption. for the AC means that you have an AC voltage source root an AC to solve questions like this you have to solve it two phases for the voltage VN greater than or equal zero or VN less than or equal zero we have many possible connections of the diode we may have diodes in parallel or in series or a combination of them we may solve more examples in the coming lectures okay This is all for this lecture.